Yes.
Whoa, leaving just Ragna?
Yeah.
And okay, so I've talked about this character. People put this character pretty low on the tier list. They say he's not that great. But guess what, guys? Ragna's in top 8. What are you going to say now?
Yeah.
Because at the same time, I think Ragna has some pretty good buttons that come from his own very own game, Blaze Blue. So, and it's easier.
Yep.
He's an easier combo monster now, and he actually does really solid damage. But the thing is, he lacks neutral.
Yeah.
And that's a big thing in this game.
Yeah.
So,
and he's very solid, though, once he's in. He's in. He's a very solid. Very solid character.
I definitely think Hyde covers his mistakes.
Yeah. And for B-Boy Dragon, though, B-Boy Dragon plays, he's actually a DOA player.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Interesting.
But he loves Ruby so much that he picked up this game.
He picked up Ruby and Blake.
Yup.
Because he couldn't pick two Rubies.
You know, he couldn't pick the whole team. So he's like, I'm picking my favorite two characters.
He's like, can I pick the whole team Ruby and just like have four characters on the screen all at once?
Yup, that's what he wants. But for him, this is his team. He loves Ruby. They're all often go with 9 feet. But yeah, okay. B-Boy Dragon takes very much advantage of the cross game. He takes a full advantage of it.
Okay, that's important because I feel like people have to start using the cross gauge a lot more. It's a very vital point to the game. It's almost like any other game that has their own specific unique thing, and they want to use that as the control in the game.
Yeah, like Blitz and Guilty Gear, Barrier and CF. You want to take full advantage of what you have. So here we go, start
right now. See, using the same tactic that we saw from Diaphone earlier, DP into, you know, Blink Assist.
Yeah. So this is what B-Boy Dragon does. But the thing about the actual mix-up of that is when he switches to Ruby to Blake with gunshots, that's real. But when he does when he switches from Ruby to Blake, that's not real. The gunshot hovering, you have time to go jump. You have time to jump. And Boom did that a lot of times.
He is a cross-tag monster right now. He is just cross-tagging as much as possible.
Yup. And here comes... Oh. Wow, B-Boy Dragon off the super.
And it is very hard to punish that. It is very fast on recovery compared to most supers.
Yep.
Oh, man, he's really doing this.
Yup.
And out of all the players we've seen him use, he's the one who used it the most.
Yeah. And the countermeasures against that, if you check Omnislice Twitter, it's on his pin. The way you countermeasure against that is either you need to put the character that's in and block stun first, or just like try to hit it. But whoa.
So here's something interesting. He did 5C, which is very unsafe afterwards to do, because you just lose your turn. But at the same time, if you press something, you get hit.
Yeah.
Very nice combo here.
Yep.
But at the same time, he tried to tag out to get the invul frames.
Yup. Yeah, like, nice bait by B-Boy Dragon.
Is he going to be able to finish? He doesn't have super. Okay. Corner's a little bit interesting for Blake. It makes it a little bit harder for her combos.
All right, and actually, Hyde's actually really good. Very interesting. Because Hyde is the only two characters in the game that can do very massive chip, and it's a true block stream. Let's see if SoulHeart knows it. Yup.
Oh, look at the chip.
Yeah, EX Orbiter does a lot of chip. Oh, and he gets a clean hit. Yup.
Bye-bye, B-Boy Dragon. Go B-Boy and do a spin-a-rooney somewhere else.
Yup. So I feel someone on commentary yesterday were asking, does Hyde do to particularly well against Ruby? I think it does well, but he doesn't do particularly well against Ruby. Because Hyde also has very big normals. Like, they're not destroying like Ruby's, but they cover the space they need to, which is really good. Very solid character.
And plus, if he throws out his EX Fireball, you got to also remember that will go through any of Ruby's gunshots. So that's definitely a pressure tool for him.
Yup. So here we go, game two.
And actually, SoulHeart kind of like playing very off at that time. Like,
yeah.
He's kind of knowing what B-Boy Dragon wants to do.
Yeah, which is using the assist gauge, using the cross meter. He wants to use it a lot. He literally utilizes on that. He wants to left-right you over and over. Go ahead.
I like that Soul actually used his cross burst there, just so that he'd actually match up with B-Boy Dragon, knowing that he won't have to worry about getting ousted by an assist combo.
Yeah, but B-Boy Dragon did a risky Dragon Punch, and SoulHeart tried to do the auto confirm. Well, I'm saying auto, but he tried to do the best confirm he could do, but it just didn't pay off. But here we go, now he's doing a much better convert. Oh, he could have got a little more.
I'm surprised B-Boy Dragon not opting to go for a cross burst there.
Yeah.
It would have been such a good point to do it and save himself all this damage.
Yeah, and here comes Blake, though. Really far-reaching normals. Oh, but he punches Ruby and Blake.
He says, get that big stuff out of here.
And I think SoulHeart recognizes that, hey, B-Boy Dragon likes to take a lot of risks that are very unwarranted. And it's like, see? He tried to throw right there. It's like... I think he has to read on B-Boy Dragon.
Oh my god, this is gonna hurt. Wait.
Yeah, you don't do gyro vortex unless you do it very, you have to do it very, very delayed. So what he wanted to do is do double super, but he couldn't.
Oh man, this is gonna hurt. Even though she's in Soul Resonance, it should kill.
Yup.
Yeah. I feel like SoulHeartRS is kind of just like taking over control of the match. He's like, you really don't understand that you're using a lot of your cross gauge and you're calling out assists randomly and it's getting you hurt.
Yeah,
and that's a very heavy damage team.
Yeah, and it's too, like, B-Boy Dragon's taking a lot of risks. He's all, and he was hovering on Yang and
White. I was scared for a second. I was like, wait, he plays every Ruby character?
It was like,
this man is a Ruby god, all right?
And B-Boy Dragon also taking the music power up. He's picking Blink Beam now.
So he wasn't feeling the theme before. Yeah. He said, nah, man. Yep. Turn that off.
So, yeah, B-Boy Dragon, like, he needs to stop taking so many risks. He needs to mitigate how much risk he needs to take. I understand he wants to protect the SS, to make sure he can sandwich them, but he's taking too many risks to protect Blake, and it's like,
I feel like he has to play more neutral. Like,
yeah,
his neutral's
exactly.
Not showing here, and he has a very good neutral team.
Yeah.
And I feel like with having Blake, he should be pressuring with Ruby and getting a chance for Ruby to get started. If not, let's play the Blake lame game, you know, call her out enough times.
Yeah, and it's like, Ruby has very disjointed hitbox, and there we go.
Whoa, big damage about to happen to them.
Yeah, so hard. It's like, no, like, I'm dictating the pace now. Like, you're not gonna have a chance to do what you want to do. I'm gonna play, not
that,
you.
That was a full lockout combo there. And oh, man.
Oh, so hard. Now, so hard was like, my turn now. It's my turn to sandwich. But unfortunately, he didn't do a true string, so he just got out.
And this is what we're talking about. B-Boy Dragon playing that neutral.
Yep.
And it's finally showing he can start doing stuff and drops the combo. I feel like he needs to get SoulHeartRS to the corner and start just pressuring him and really trying to open him up and do some damage here.
Yeah. Yeah. I feel if B-Boy Dragon played more neutral, he'll be fine. But it's like he just wants a sandwich. And SoulHeartRS tried to be clever. He tried to switch, hide out, and make him like try to punish hide. But he switched to random, but random got punished anyway.
And SoulHeartRS opted to use cross burst there, even though B-Boy Dragon didn't have any cross gauge assist to follow the combos.
Y'all, and good RPS by SoulHeartRS. He recognized the push flag and went like, oh,
no super to finish.
Yeah.
I guess he thought it would just kill.
Yeah, I guess so.
Oh, gets the overhead. Says, you know, it's time to go home, B-Boy Dragon, unless you can make something happen here.
Yup. There we go.
Oh, man. Tries to 5C, double 5C. Overhead. Not going to be dead, though. Didn't get it. Excellent.
Oh, wow, nice DP to EX bus off. Oh, she did it again.
SoulHeartRS not caring. He's like, hey, man, look, you don't have that many options left.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
There we go.
That was the classic Ragnar from, like, watching BlazBlue. You were like, he's like, oh, you jumped in? Okay, anti-air.
Y'all, the classic. The Philadelphia special, just like, oh, here comes 6A. Like,
just get down from there. What are you doing?
What are you doing?